Today is the first day of winter. You know what that means? It means comfort food. Oh, I love comfort food in the chilly months. We've brought in celebrity chef Brad Sloane to show us how to whip up the most delicious winter warmer, a yummy meat pie. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Now, this is one of your most popular dishes. How do we begin to make it?
It is. It's going great guns at the Town Hall Hotel in Balmain.
Yes.
Right, so what we're going to do is we're going to start with some really nice free-range pork shoulder.
So pork?
That, yeah, pork. So we've got some that. We've got a little bit of flour. Just going to put that in there.
Now, Brad, I reckon there are two types of people in this world. People who like chunky pies and people who like the mushy meat pies, which is me.
Us and them.
Yes, exactly. So why do you like the chunkier style?
I just
think... Do you want to put that in the pan?
Oh, I do.
Yeah. Excuse me.
So if you could put that in there, that'd be great. I don't know. I just really like that texture from the pie.
Okay.
And you get, nice big chunks of meat. I love that.
Yeah, so beautiful.
You're the them. You like the...
I'm the them.
What else do you want with this meat?
Right, so we're just going to saute off that pork in there and just get a bit of colour in it in a nice pan. Then we're going to throw some onions, some garlic and some thyme in there.
Ooh.
And then we're going to just turn that up a little bit.
Yeah.
Sorry. And we'll just throw the cider and the chicken stock in there and cook that up.
Okay.
And what we're doing
now,
I'm going to get you onto...
Let me just roll up my sleeves.
Yeah, roll those up. Just sleeves in half. So what I've got, some little stainless steel rings here.
Ah.
So what we're doing is we're lining that with some short crust pastry. So what we'll start with is a round.
Yes.
Straight in there.
Okay.
And then we've got some...
Have you made the pastry or have you bought the pastry?
I've just bought this one.
I think prepared pastry is much easier.
Save yourself the headaches.
So what we're going to do is we're going to line that around and we're going to... Just overlap that on the bottom by about a centimetre, if you can do that for me.
Yep.
And then just crimp it all together.
Crimp it.
There you go, in your item.
Okay. I'll turn it up a bit more.
Yeah, turn it up. We might just
add
the onion.
A bit more oil.
Yeah, a little bit more oil. So we want to get a lot more colour on it than that if we can, but for TV's sake, we're going to
throw
the onions in.
Do you need to spray?
I did spray that a little bit just so it doesn't stick.
What's that?
Onions, a little bit of garlic.
Garlic, which you've chopped up.
I did. Some rosemary, some fresh rosemary. These hard herbs are just screaming of winter. Love them.
Could you use a muffin tray and make little teeny tiny pies?
And what
might be good for school lunches?
You could.
Yeah.
That was fresh thyme and fresh rosemary. So these beautiful herbs are, winter wonderland there.
Yum.
Right. So we're just going to saute that off. Now, we'd like to really cook that down a little bit more.
Yes, we'd cook it more if we were doing it at home. But this
is what we're going to do is got a bottle of apple cider. Get that in there.
Ooh. Apple cider, that's interesting.
Would go well with the pork, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
it does.
Good.
Yep.
It goes very well.
Okay.
So we've got that, and we're just going to put a little bit of chicken stock in there as well.
So we let it simmer for a while.
And that's going to simmer for 40, 50 minutes, depending on how hot your stove is. But we want it just a nice... sort of not too hot.
Okay,
I'm just going to bang a lid on
now
that.
Now, you've made some of the filler.
How did you go with the...
Not great.
Right.
Not great, no. Yours looks really good, though. So do you cook it actually in the metal ring?
We do.
Okay.
So what we do, we've got...
Now, this is the one already cooked, isn't it?
Wow.
So what we do...
Yep. Put that down there. Yep.
We're just going to spoon the pie mix in.
Fantastic. How good does that look?
So after that's finished cooking as well, I usually put some green peppercorns through it.
Oh.
Which just gives it a nice little sort of...
Bit of a kick?
Yeah, a little bit of a kick and a nice little sort of vinegary kind of bite as well.
Mm.
So we want to leave about a centimetre from the top.
Okay. Why is that?
Then,
Does it expand?
We want a little bit of air in between the meat and the pastry.
Okay.
So that's the short crust. So what we're going to do now is we're going to put a little bit of puff pastry on top.
Ah.
So,
to make it all fancy
if you put
on
that
top.
On top and give that a nice little crimp.
Okay.
And I'm just going to grab a little knife there. Later.
And you've got some fancy seeds on top.
Oh, yes, we do. So, carrots. These are, we're going to serve this with some mashed potato and I'm going to put a little bit of butter in that pan. And if you could drop those in there.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Right.
And this is where you actually paint on the butter, yeah?
Well, what we're going to do is we're just going to put that puff pastry on, give it a little trim off.
Ah.
That pastry a bit of a trim off. All right.
Okay.
And we're going to brush that with a little bit of egg yolk.
Yep, can I do that?
You can.
Fab.
And, the egg yolk will help it brown, won't it? Some mixture of sesame seeds and poppy seeds. So that butter's going to give them nice little...
Have you cooked them or is that, are they raw?
I have cooked them. I've given them a little blanch.
You've blanched them?
I've blanched them, yeah.
Hot water.
But generally I would just put them in a pan, a little bit of butter, a little bit of honey.
Ooh, honey.
Yeah, there we go.
Actually, carrots and something sweet work really well, don't they?
They do. It just brings out the flavour of the carrots.
I'm getting hungry doing this.
A little bit of salt. Mm. And we're also going to put a little bit of fresh thyme in there as well. Okay. Wow, you're an artist.
There you go.
Right, so that's it. Pretty much that simple.
Yep.
And we're going to...
And how long to put that in the oven for?
That would go in the oven for about 20 minutes.
Wow, that's quick.
It's pretty quick. So, because the pie meat's already cooked.
Quite high?
About 200 degrees.
Wow.
The meat's already cooked. You're just cooking the pastry and reheating the pie, essentially.
You
could do that pie mix a day before, all that kind of thing.
How fantastic. Cool. And this is how it ends up. It looks gorgeous. What do you make of people putting sauce on pies?
This I've put a jus with that, a pork jus, where it's got some bacon, some onions and some seeded mustard in it. And I just find that really boosts up the flavour because the pie is slightly sweet and that savoury jus just kind
Wince if someone put tomato sauce on it?
It's okay.
Yes, I get that a little bit.
We won't.
And I let people do their own thing, but... Me personally, no.
And if you would rather someone else make this for you, like Brad, for example, you can head to the Town Hall Hotel Balmain in Sydney. This is his signature dish. It's worth a visit. Thank you so much for coming in. Yeah, we're going to taste this.